Hello everyone, this is Kamal Bunkar and we are working on Android course. Okay, so I just started this Android course live session. Okay, so in last session we were working on layout types. We have learned about the linear layout, relative layout, okay, and we were working on tab layout and grid layout. So there we faced some problem. So actually I will resolve this problem. That is, actually it is not a problem, so there is some confusion. That's it. Okay, so let's start with today's session. In today's session we will work on a tab layout, grid layout, and then we will work on the activity side. So we will see how to use this text view button in activity, okay, and what is the null pointer error. Okay, so most of the developer beginners, they face the null pointer exception. Even the expert also face the null pointer exception. There is a no exceptional case. Okay, everybody face the null pointer exception. So how to find the null pointer and what, how to resolve the error. Okay, so this is the main issue. Okay, and actually if you know how to find the actual problem, so you can resolve it. Okay, so I will tell you the methods too. Okay, so let's start today's session. Okay, so we have, okay, so 4 or 5 friends. Okay, so in yesterday's session, actually I put this columns, but it was not reflecting over there. So there is a one problems, one mistake that I do. So let me close it. Okay, if I actually, there you can see there is right now two rows, okay, 1 and 2. So first one property of this tab layout is the column width. Suppose there is two row, okay, so right now it is in second column, and there is a in second row second column. Okay, suppose there is third row third column. Okay, so the column width will be the width of the largest column that available on that that column number. Okay, so suppose this first column is a widest one, okay, and these two column is the small as compared to this first one, but the second and for the third column the width will be same as the column number one. Okay, so this is the first thing about the tab layout. And second thing is, suppose I remove this second row, suppose, okay, so there you can see there is a no change, you can't see the change. Okay, so every child is in a linear manner because I have put it there. So by default there is a linear manner, it don't affect the column number because there is a no other row. Okay, so this is the second point. If there is a no other row, only single row, the everything will be in a linear manner. Okay, so if I put the second row, now you can see if I change, look, for this column 4, means fourth column, I have put the column number as a 1, and this fifth I have put the column number as a 4. If suppose I change it 3 4, so let's see what happened. So there is a 1 2, but third column is not there. This is the fourth column, this is a fourth column, or even this 2 2, this 2 2 is also column number fourth. The column number third is missing there. Okay, so it won't put the white space for column number four. Okay, it will add all the child in a linear manner. So if I suppose I change this two as a three, so then it will create a space for third column, and then it will be in fourth position. So 1 2 3 4, and this one is the sixth. Right now there is no fifth, so it will be sixth. Okay, so this is the table layout. Okay, you can create it. By default it is a linear. If you have other row, then it becomes it will treat like a tab layout or table layout. Okay, we often use this table layout. We we normally use the linear layout and relative layout, and okay. So there is nothing else about this table layout. Just you need to create a row. If you want, you can create multiple rows. Just if I put another row, so it will be goes there. I can change the column number as 2, so it become in a second position. Oh, sorry, not column number, column number 2. Okay, so this is how you can change the orientation. Okay, so now come to the next part, that is a grid layout. Okay, in grid layout, yesterday I am using a num column, that is a wrong, it is a column count. The keyword is column count. So if I want three child in a row or two child in a row, so I can write the number there. So if I change it like a three child, okay, so there you can see the orientation has changed, 1, 2, 3. If I want four child will be there. So look, grid layout, main layout is a grid layout. Inside it, all the child is there one by one. Okay, there is no other linear layout, relative layout inside this grid layout. Just you need to define how many child you want in a row. So if I want one child in a row, so it become a list. Okay, so this is it for grid layout. Okay, so there is also a grid view, list view. Okay, so these are the list. Actually grid view is also a list type. Okay, when we work on adapter, means list view, recycle view, that time we will work on grid view also. Okay, so this is a little bit different concept, so, but we will work on it. Okay, so all the properties of this text view, buttons, you can put anything there. There is no restriction at all. Okay, so right now we are working with the text view, so it is a simple thing to explain all this concept. Okay, so come to the Java part. So right now it is a main activity. Where is a main? Have I put something in there? Let me close this thing, otherwise it will disturb the view. Okay, main activity. So I think all of you familiar with how to define the text view button in this main activity, but those who are new, so for them I just want to explain the concept. Okay, so right now in this layout, so, in main activity, you need to define or you need to attach the layout with this activity. If you are not writing this code, means set content view, then this activity also work. Okay, there is a no restriction that you must have the layout with the means you must have the layout associated with the activity. Okay, it is not a case. So you can run an activity without a layout. Okay, it will work. Okay, so suppose you want a layout with the activity, so you need to set content view. Okay, so over the time you can change another layout. Okay, so you can write this text content view after a few lines or after button click, so it will change the view. Okay, so suppose I want on inside button click, I want this layout to be display. What is relative layout? Okay, so inside on button click I can put it, but there is another restriction, so you need to deal with the component, means if some text view and other button is defined, so you need to again define it. So leave this part right now. Okay, so first in this layout, main active layout, I have few text view, this one. Okay, so ID of this one is text one, and for this second text 2. Okay, so I want to access this text view, means at runtime I have the username. Okay, I will get it from server and I want to display it on this text view. Okay, so to add or to change the property of this text view at runtime, you need the ID of this text view. Okay, so first you need to define which child you want to access. Okay, so every time use the private, don't use the public, otherwise suppose text view. Okay, oh, someone is trying to access, but this is a limited version. Okay, I can deny it. Let me check, is the session is on? Yeah, session is on, but only five student can allow for my limited version. I think I have to purchase the team viewer. Okay, so leave this thing, I will do it. Yeah, so text view, we want to access text view, so you need to define it first. So there you can type any name, but generally I use the name suppose it is my username. Okay, so the ID I will write it like that, user name, and I will put txt username. Normally I use this notation. Okay, and same thing I will access, mean same name I will write over there in TeamViewer. Okay, so this way I can easily identify that which text view I am accessing. Okay, now this is now we need to initialize it. This is a definition. Now initialize the text view with name, then define the type, it is a text view type. Then we are going to tell the system find by ID. Okay, find this text view by ID. So there you need to write the resource, R for resource, ID. Okay, get the resource ID, the name is text username. Okay, so this is the meaning of this line. Please find this ID in this layout where it is a text view type. Okay, so once it is done, now you can access this text view anywhere. So this text view dot, you can set all the property, set padding, set color, set text, text size, you can do anything with this text view. Okay, so I am going to use one simple thing. I am going to put one name there. Okay, so it is a Kamal Bunkar, suppose. Okay, so when I will run this code, it will display this name. Okay, so first let me run this code. So is about to start. Okay, so there we get the problem. Okay, so look, it is a crash. Okay, so to find the error, you need to click on this locket. Okay, this locket, and select the device on which you are which device you are testing your code. Okay, and there you can see the null pointer exception. Okay, so there you can see the running app name. Okay, and you have to select this one, so only selected app. Okay, and there you can set this one or error log. It is all up to you. Okay, so look, click on it. So what there is null pointer exception. Okay. So we get null pointer exception on this ID, this text view. But look, the ID is correct, it's look correct, text view username, I have defined the same ID over there, okay, but it is still showing this error. Why? Because look, there is a different types, three layout, okay, but in this layout and in this layout, the ID of this text view or other parameter is missing, means there we have only one text view. There is also we have only one text view, need two text view, but in this layout there is four text view. Okay, so this is what I was telling on yesterday session. So it must be same on all the layout. Okay, you can change the design, but the ID and other items, number of item must be same. Okay. Okay, so now we can try it. Okay, so there. Okay, now it is working fine. There you can see the name Kamal Bunkar. Okay, and in log, I think I have put it there. So this is Kamal SD and name Kamal. Okay, so now you get the idea about the null pointer and how to find it. So this is the first thing. Now, second case is suppose. Let me check whether it work or not. Okay, so now it is an integer value, okay, and I am trying to set it on text view. Okay, so at a first look, it's there is no error. Okay, so you can't see the error over there. But let me run this code. Then we can check. Normally, you can select this one, so you can see the idea what actually going on inside this system. Okay. I think I need to again run. Sometime it failed to run on system. Okay, so there you can see it again crashed. Now I want to see the error. Okay, so sometime you will see that this logcat is continue going on. So when you have select this option, okay, so but now you want how to find the error, where is this error. Okay, so what you need to do, first select this error there. Okay, don't close it, don't click reopen, okay? Just leave it as it is, okay? Just go inside this log, select this option error, then no filter. So when you click no filter, it will show all the error that occur on your system. So then go upside, okay? So then you will find your application name, okay? Your application name and other things. There you can see main activity, whatever log you have written, so you can find it, okay? Or even you can check the their package name. It is a package name actually. Okay, so now look, click on this first is resource not found exception, okay? And on which line? This line. So every time you have to click on this blue line first, okay? So it will tell you the at which line you are getting the error, okay? So look, it is there any error? No, there is no red line, you can't see. But then you need to read about this error, resource not found exception, okay? String resource ID is blank, okay? So look, why it is happening? So because this is a text view and we are calling method set text, okay? Set text method require only string value, okay? You can't pass the integer or floating number or double number in this text, in this set text method, okay? So if you want to display it, so you need to convert to this integer value in a string value, okay? The simple method is just call this one string dot value of, okay? So then you can put this name value inside it, okay? So this way you can convert any integer floating value in a string format, okay? Same thing you can do with the integer to string or string to integer, both way. So suppose I want to convert string into integer, so I will write integer dot value of now string name. So there is my string name is 12, so I will get 12 as an integer after this code, okay? So same thing you can do with the floating value, float dot value of, double dot value of, you can use it, okay? Don't use a int for small I, don't use int dot value of, okay? It is wrong. Or even the small float, it is also wrong, okay? Now now I have put this integer value in a string format, okay? Now again check whether it is working or not. So reset all this thing and run the code. Okay, so there you can see the value is 12 now, okay? Value is 12 now. Okay, so now once again see same error in a different way, okay? So suppose I have a one function, okay? So right now, and this is a very straightforward and simple way, but when we work on project, okay, so there we have many functions, okay? And sometime we used to work on adapter and other class. So means from this activity I will call another class, and from this class I will call another class or another functions, okay? This can be happen. So how to find the error? So suppose I have one function in this activity, so you can name it anything, get get int value, you can name it anything, nothing big it's here. So it is a public void get value, okay? So in this function, what I am doing, I am doing a simple thing. Okay, so suppose it is a, look, cut it from there, and name value, okay? Again it will throw the error definitely, but look what the log will say about it, okay? whatever I am doing right now, it is about the null pointer exception and how to trace the error. Okay, it is like finding the trail, or you can say it is a backtracking approach. Okay, so I think it has run or not. No. Okay, so again I get the error. Okay, but this time there is a two blue lines. Okay, earlier there was one single line, but this time it is a two blue lines. Okay, so the error is same because we are trying to put integer in a string format. So look, so click on this line. Okay, so it is on 26, line number 26, and click on there, line number 33. Okay, so your actual line where you are occurring the error, it will be on a top. Okay, and below it there is a other function from where you are calling this method. Okay, so from this method, so this second line is telling that this function, in this function there is error. When you will go inside this function, you will find the actual problem. Okay, so in real project, sometime you will see 4 or 5 blue lines over there. So you can directly go there, or you can click one by one and find the trail. Okay, actually when we work on project, so sometime we pass the actual value from main activity to the third child, or means third class or fourth class. Okay, so means from main activity I will pass some value to second child. Okay, then pass to second third child, like that I do. Okay, so then we have to track the sequence from where I am calling all these things, and I have to put the log. Okay, so this is correct. This is the second point. Now suppose I do one more thing. So again I am going to put string dot value of. Okay, so now there is no error. But suppose I forget to define this thing. Okay, suppose I forget to define this thing, then it will again throw me the error. So this time it will be right now this is a resource not found, but when I will run this code, this time it is a null pointer because this object text view is not initialized yet. It is defined over there but not initialized. Okay, so again you can see it has run, but this time it is a null pointer exception, object reference, null object reference. So there it is again showing on same line, same function, but now you will see what is the error over there. So there you need to do two things. Okay, normally the people ask me about this null pointer exception, they are getting that null pointer exception, but they don't print the log. Okay, so there is a look at the this line. First look at the line where you are occurring error. Okay, so there is two object, one is this text view, second is your value. This can create problems. Okay, you have to find how many object or how many parameters are there in this line of code. Okay, then one by one track it. So first put the log, you can write anything, or activity name is best. Okay, so normally we first print this values. Okay, whether it is null or not, so name, value, then print it. Okay, this way I can check on log. So before this line means this line is creating problem, so just before this line I will put a log. Okay, so I will again run, definitely it will crash, no problem. But I can see that this variable, this integer is not null, it has some value. Okay, so now I make sure that this is not creating problem, that means it is creating problem, the second object. Okay, then I will find the trail of this object. So I will search it, how many times I have defined it, main where I am using it. So I will see that suppose this line is not there, suppose, okay. So I will see that there it is defined in two times. One is as a global object, and second time it is directly defined over there to set the text. So then I can find that, oh yeah, I missed the initialization, okay. So you need to define it, okay. So this is the method that you have to follow. Okay, so there, if suppose now everything is correct. So sometimes user do this type of mistakes too. They initialize the name. Oh, sorry. Suppose it is not there. No, yeah, this is not cached right now. Sometime. Okay, so it is not available right now. Okay, so leave this thing. Okay, so now you got the idea about the null pointer and how to find it. Okay, and suppose I 12 and string dot value of these things. Leave this thing as it is. Okay. Now do one thing. We are going to design one layout. This is a login form. So when we start working, so first thing we need is a login form. Okay. So in login form, I need one edit text, two edit text, phone number, password, and button. Okay. And on button click, I will get the password and phone number, and I will do some activity with it. Okay. So let's create one layout or work on any existing layout. So create one, no problem. So I am using a linear layout right now, not a big deal. Okay. So I need two edit text. Okay. So user can put input. So it is a edit text. It will be wrap content, Android ID. I need user name one. Okay, so put some margin so I can access it. Top as a 20 dp. Okay, and second is for password. Okay, and third is a button. Android ID is BTN submit. So yeah, there need a text. So I need text. Text is a submit. Okay. So look, by default, if you forget to define the orientation of this linear layout, so by default it will be horizontal. Okay, but I want it in a vertical. So orientation is vertical. Now it is there. I can put this right now. Gravity is left. This is a default feature. So I can set the gravity. So when I will set the gravity, it will apply on this child. Okay. Gravity center. So everything will be there. It is a center means center horizontal and center vertical. If I want only center horizontal, so it will be there. Okay. So now this text view is empty. There user can't judge anything what is all about. Okay, so you can put hint. So Android hint there. So use the string name or other name. So right now I am using hard code, but you have to use string.xml file only. Okay, so user name. Okay, so Now it is good. So I think you can't see it. Okay, now you can see it. And there, Android hint for password. Okay, so you can change the color as I told you in last session. Use hint color. Sorry, hint color. Where is color hint? Yeah, text color hint, capital H. That's why it is not getting it. So I can use a pure black or other colors. So it will apply over there. Okay, so you can change, no problem. Okay, good. So what I want right now, I am going to explain you a simple concept. Then we will work on some advanced concept on this edit text. Okay, so in some login form, you see you just type the name and hit the enter button. Okay, so when you will hit the enter button, so this edit text will move to the next box. Okay, so to use it, you can do one thing, means you need to define, or one more thing, if suppose right now there is no other feature, no other option I have defined there, so if I run this code and I will write over there and put the hint enter button, so it will create a second line. Okay, so let me, it is a login form, so make it comment. It is taking time, so yeah, now okay, so this is my edit text. So if suppose I am writing something and putting enter button, okay, so you can use this one too. I am using a keyboard. Okay, so it is creating a new line, but in login form we don't want this new lines. Okay, so what you need to do, you need to define one property, that is single line as a true. Okay, single line as a true. Okay, so but this single line, I think sometimes it create problems, okay, in some phones. So you need to define one more property, that is Android max line. Max line means maximum number of line you want. So it is a one. Okay, so when I will run this code, so on enter button click, it won't go, it won't create a new line. Okay, so type something and hit. So there you can see it moves to the next field. Okay, because this property is now set, single line and max line as a true. Oh, where is my emulator? Oh, where is my emulator? Is go out of view. Okay, so let me close it. I think it won't come again. Okay, so now you get the idea about this edit tags. Okay, so same thing you can apply on other box. Okay, so this time it will go to the submit this button. Okay, but again one more thing that I want to show you. Let me run the emulator, otherwise it create. Okay, so now in some form you have seen that when a user write username then password and then he will enter a submit button. Okay, so this means when he type the password and hit enter button. Okay, so this submit button on click method will automatically called. Okay, so means the system send the request to the server and do some other task. Okay, so to define this type of property we need editor information. Okay, so actually it is a action IME options. Okay, this one, so there you can define action done, action go, action send. Okay, so this action you can define. I will explain it to you because we need to write the code in activity, that is the editor info. So right now I am leaving this thing. Okay, we will work on this concept when we will working on send data to server and some login form. Okay, that time I will explain this concept because right now it is a very okay, so we are in beginner stage, so we can't okay so this is two edit tags. One is the password and username and this one is submit button. Okay, so now when user will click submit button, I want a value that user have defined in this username and password. Okay, so first we need to access this edit tags and buttons in our activity. Okay, so define it first private, this is the edit text. Edit text first is username and second is password. Okay, so concept is same. Username is equal to edit text type find view by id r dot id, name is what is username one, and the password is again it is edit text type find view by id r dot id. Android studio do most of the task for you. You just need to write the initials, so it will give you the method name, so don't worry about it. Okay, so submit button btn. Okay, so it is a submit button is equal to button type find view by r dot id dot submit button. Okay, so now on submit button click, I want some actions to be performed. So you can use submit button, the name of object dot set on click listener. Okay, so you need to just write the initials. Okay, you have to know the method name only. Okay, so just type initials, so it will do all the tasks. So look, this method require on click listeners. Okay, so what I am going to do, just click enter then new, so it will pop up you the which method you have to write over there. So write new on, so it will automatically give you the other name. Just type initials and hit submit. Okay, so there inside this on click you can perform your task. Okay, so look, this method you can call in any object, okay? Even in a edit text, even in a text view, you can call this object, okay? I think in some object is not available. So suppose this text view is available, so you can call this set on click listener on this text view too. Okay, it is free form. You can access. You can use it. Okay, so now what I want when user submit, I want the text user has written on this username and password. So to get the value. So first you need to use username means the object name dot, this time we want get value, we are getting the value, so use get text and also use to string. So we are explicitly telling to the system that whatever value written in this username, it must be in a string format. Okay, so every time use this to string. Okay, so now you have value there, so you can use it in a temporary variable. Okay, temp username, or you can directly work with this one, not a big deal. So same thing you can do with the password dot get text, sorry, get text dot to string. Okay, so now I can send this username and password to our server, okay? But there is a one case, okay? So suppose user once the app is run, so user without typing any name, username and password, he hit the submit button. So that time, suppose you are sending this value to your server, okay? So means there you will call some function name and you are trying to pass this value, so it will throw a null pointer because this text view contain nothing. Okay, so suppose I just want to print this value, suppose, okay, so log.e main activity username. Okay, so there is a temp username. So same thing you can do with the password too, but right now. Okay, so please select this one if you are seeing log is continue moving, so you can select this option. Okay, select the app name and select this option, so it becomes stable. Okay. So now without typing any name, I am going to hit this button, submit button. Okay, so right now it is a blank. Okay, no problem. So sometime you will see the null pointer if you are trying to do with work with this temp user. Right now it is not throwing error, but sometime it give you error. Okay, so what you need to do, you need to check whether it is null or whether it is blank or not. Okay, so there is a simple method, you can use text utility. So first I want to when user submit, I will check whether this box is empty or not, user password is empty or not. So I will put if condition, if, and use the utility text utility dot, there is a method name is empty. Okay, is mpt and then pass this string, entire string. You can pass this string or you can use direct edit text name. So we generally use the direct edit text name because I don't we don't want system will go like create another variable, another string and then work on it. Okay, so minimum the string or minimum the object you define on your code, so it will be run very fast. Okay, so there, so it will be written a log. I'm going to return a log, and else case, if it is empty, so it will write a username is empty. This method will return true and false. Okay, and in else case username is not empty, so this is for display purpose only, not empty. Okay, so hit the submit button. So what we can see, username is empty, username is empty. Okay, so this text utility will detect this username is empty, so you can display a pop-up message and toss message you can display over there. Okay, so normally the system is first check first field username then password. Okay, so copy it. In else case, I am checking it with for it for password. Okay, then this password is empty, so I will write the message as password is empty. Password is empty, and then else case. So there everything is good, means user has written the password, because if user has written password it won't go inside this if, it won't if, oh sorry, username and password is written, so it won't go inside this if, and this if it will directly go into this else part. So there I can send this data to server or I can do anything with it. Okay, so this is one thing. Okay, now the second thing is, suppose in my form there is a phone number. Okay, so this is not username, it becomes a phone number. So user can, right now you can see the keyboard, it is a alphanumeric keyboard. I can type the character and I can type the number and symbols too. Okay, but I want user must type number only. Okay, so suppose it is a phone number, so I want user must type the number only. So suppose it is a number, phone number. Okay, so what I need to define, I need to define one input type. Okay, so there you can see there is a method format text type. If I want decimal number, so I can use number decimal. I want only integer number, so I can use number. So phone number is a number, so I can use this number or I can use this phone. Okay, you can use any of these options. There is a date format, password type also. So if suppose user type the password, so it will be display ** every time. Right now if I type anything there, so it will display the character there, so I can change it. Okay, so do it. Right now I want it as a phone. And for this one, Android input type as a password. Okay, so there is a text password, number password. So if your password can be alphanumeric, so you can use text password. Okay, Okay, so there you can see the keyboard. Now this keyboard becomes numeric keyboard. Okay, so there you can see there is plus sign and minus signs too. So user can type country code. Okay, but if you want, user can't type the country code. Like for India, it is a plus 91. Okay, and for other countries, it is a other. Okay, so if you want, user can type only the number. So you can change it as a number only. Okay, and there in password field, so look, now it become a star. Okay, and submit. So your phone number, if I write something, so now the phone number is this one. Okay. Okay, so I think it is enough for today's session. So do you have any question for today's session? Today we are already very overcrowded. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, please ask me the question, what you want. I am unmuting you. Yeah, you can say anything, or you can use the chat box, both the option available for you. He is Ishaq Ramadhani from Malaysia. Please ask me the question. Can you hear me? Do you have any question? Main activity dot Java. Can you go there? Okay, so main activity dot Java. I want to, yes, there, and now you can see all the activity. There is unnecessary space. Yeah, I think you can see it. How to use trim. Okay, trim, yeah. So it is a simple concept. Now we have a string there. So trim is actually used for removing white space. Suppose this is the string, is something like that. Username is empty and there is a space. There is a space, there is a space, there is a space. Okay, so username, normally username should not contain white space. Okay, in any app, in any web login form, you can't see that your username contain the blank space. Okay, so we need to remove this blank space. So we can call the simple method, that is trim. You can apply this method on any string. Okay, so first thing, I'm using this, temp user dot trim. Okay, and what I am doing, so it will, this method will remove all this white space, all this white space, and again you can save same the return string, whatever string will return after this code, it will again store in temp user. Okay, so now my string, suppose this is my string, so it become like that. Okay, and even this last white space, it will be removed from the string. Okay, so this is a basic Java concept, and I can apply this in there too. So I can use trim there directly. Okay, so this is edit text, get text, it become in a string, and now apply the trim. Okay, so basic concept is this trim method will apply on a string only. Okay, any other question? Okay. So if there is any other question, so please ask me. So I think there is no other question for use. Okay, so so I am going to close this session, and if you have any question, you can ask me on WhatsApp too, and you can ask me on Facebook too. Okay, bye, and see you in tomorrow session.